My name is Khris Lloyd. I'm the procurement logistics manager for the brewery.
And I'm Matt Lutin. I'm the marketing manager, which also kind of wears a number of hats at a brewery our size. The impetus for the brewery started in 2010. It took a couple years to become an official commercial brewery. That opened in August 2012, that we're approaching 10 years on. Tiny little brewery, almost immediate success with our community, as I said. And it grew, and we had to open another brewery just up the street in 2015. That's where our tap room is now.
With everything shifting to cans, we suddenly found ourselves quite busy with our current production line, almost to the point where we were looking at our future and really wondering how we were going to keep up with it. So it was at that point we decided, hey, there are really some big advantages here to upgrading our canning line. And in that process, you know, of course, running a faster canning line, you need a lot more CO2. In that case, we were using CO2 previously. With all of the things going on in the world, CO2 was actually a pretty difficult resource to get. And so talking to all the various suppliers about getting in a bigger system and getting more CO2 and everything, the outlook was not very supportive of this, you know, high quality, very fast canning line that we were trying to bring in. And so I had heard from another brewery, and this was a couple years before this, but they were using nitrogen for some of their brewery process. And I thought, well, I wonder if that would be viable for this high speed canning line or even just our entire brewery. So I went down that path and found Rogers. You guys knew the food industry really well and, you know, had ample engineers and technicians to give me all of the answers to my questions that I had, because I really knew very little about how that worked at the time. And so, you know, the appeal of having someone local that, you know, I could pick up the phone and theoretically they could be here in a couple hours, you know, worst case scenario, was just extremely valuable, you know, because for us, you know, we only have so many tanks. We only have so much volume that we can produce. And if a tank is delayed by even a day or two, well, we can't run our canning line because we have no fresh air. You know, that's less beer that we can make overall. And that's super critical. And the air compressor not only runs, you know, some of the critical parts of our filler, but essentially every piece of our canning line has some pretty critical compressed air requirement. So if something goes down with our air compressor, we're basically shut down for production, not only on the packaging side, but it also would affect our brewing side, our entire brewery, really. So, and when I started getting results back from the request for proposal that I had sent out, you know, I could just really see through that sales process with Harini, our sales rep, that she also really was extremely knowledgeable about both, you know, compressed air and the nitrogen side and just how that's generally used in food processing as well, which was really comforting. You know, the rep had that knowledge and could answer me right on the spot and really kind of guide that process to where we needed it to be to make sure everything worked, was very comforting. It was very comforting. Made the whole process a lot easier. The nitrogen system was sized to essentially meet the demands of our canning line, plus the gas that it takes to essentially push the beer out of the tank to get to the canning line, and the few other processes around the brewery that we need nitrogen for. One thing that was a really great experience and helped us in a very interesting predicament. So the great thing about the nitrogen generator is, you know, you have various sizes to get your flow through rates. And so when we sized the system, I did make a small boo-boo, and I never actually mentioned that we were trying to get a particular flow rate of CO2. I was saying, no, we need this flow rate of nitrogen. And it turns out that there's actually a difference there. So when we fired up our canning line, we were actually having some trouble keeping up. And after, you know, a very quick phone call with the engineering team there, they told us, you know, well, what are you running your purity level at? The techs came out and made a quick setting adjustment on the nitrogen generator, and we got more than enough flow rate, and everything was wonderful. So I want to say I really appreciated the fact that your team had the knowledge and just the way that the equipment was set up to where, you know, we weren't stuck. There was a very easy solution. So what's great is there's a number on the side of the air compressor that we can call, and it's I think it's a 24-hour line. And so somebody answers, and we can tell them what our issues are, and they troubleshoot it with us on the phone. And like I said, most of the time, it's just, no, you just need to reset this light or something. but there have been a couple instances where, you know, we thought we needed an emergency service, and the tech was able to get out here, you know, that same day. And again, turns out, you know, we were okay. But just the fact that that's even a possibility, and you guys have really, you know, lived up to that. You know, not only are you saying that techs are locally available and there when you need them, but they actually were. To wrap it all up, you guys were able to put together a really nice financing package for us. So looking at the ROI, we figured in almost less than a year, you know, it would pay for itself, which was pretty phenomenal.